carries who really come in and come into the fold. Certain carries like Animage are like, okay, I'm ready. I'm ready to fully take team fights now. And you don't see a whole lot of games. I mean, obviously, we just ended a series that went quite late, but you don't see too many games really going past the 60-minute marker, I feel. 10 seconds
remaining. Now, VP, Storm is there in the pool, but I don't think it really fits well with the Shadow Fiend. If you've got SF mid and then Storm safe lane, they kind of overlap with their farm timing. You can still run it. Obviously, it gives you a lot of extra mobility that you would not otherwise get.
Mm-hmm.
Because right now, relatively static heroes. Visage, Earthshaker, Shadow Fiend, they've got decent lockdown, tons of nukes, like absolutely tons of magic damage. But Team Secret, could they go for a Storm as well? Because Lina, she can space create very, very easily with that Eel Scepter if you can get it fast enough. You know, stack up the large and medium camp on the dire side, flash farm through that, get a good 12-minute Eel Scepter. Shadow Fiend could get crushed at that stage, and then you open up the jungle for the Storm Spirit. Clockwork is not going to be taking up too much space in there. He doesn't go into the jungle to farm up. He'll be roaming around looking with Alina for kills.
Right.
They could even still go for a Winter Wyvern, actually. It's pretty good against the Visage. Got those birds raining down from the sky onto the allies.
Team Secret, their response to this. Do you feel like the Earthshaker is locked down to the offlane a little bit now because of the Virtus Pro picking the Visage? This is normally a hero that's going to operate in the four position, will take a large amount of the farm. This a hard five Earthshaker, there are very few people who can really make it work, such as PPD. Hanskin does it pretty well as well.
I feel that the fact that DK Phobos is there is always going to give me that sort of 80% chance it's going to be offlane Earthshaker anyway.
Oh, yeah.
And then the Visage comes in and, yeah, it definitely raises that percentage chance. Also, now we're looking for FNG on Earthshaker. Sure, it's going to be great, but it's not one of his sort of signature heroes, really. So I feel that they'll look for their FNG hero now and then maybe leave Illidan to last, because a lot of the CIS teams have been showing this tendency to leave the one roll carry until their fifth and final pick, keeping people like Artez, Illidan kind of safe in the drafting phase from being counted out too heavily.
Silencer.
Ooh, Silencer. So they're going to run an Illidan carry Silencer. Virtus Pro have been favoring this one lately. They're one of the few teams we've seen some four position Silencers, but it's pretty much just VP who are really running the carry Silencer successfully, as they did really well versus Ninja's Pajamas. That was their very first game, I believe.
So good against Alina, and it's actually really good against the Naga Siren. You know, you pop the global, make sure there's no song to reset the fights,
right.
Try and pick her off. But against Alina, it's really exceptional, because you always Lifestrike Array, and then you cut her combo right there. No Dragon Slave, no Laguna Blade. Gives chance for heroes like the SF, Earthshaker to get their spells out, or even Mech and Fisher to turn things back around.
Yeah, and this now locks Alina into that mid lane position. There was still a chance that you would see Alina and Crystal Maiden support duo. Very unlikely, but a chance. Naga Siren should be our other support paired with the Crystal Maiden. I really like Crystal Maiden Naga Siren as a support duo. I feel like they offer this nice spread of both damage and control, and the spam of the synergy with the Crystal Maiden's aura mixed in with the Riptide and Mirror Image spam of the Naga Siren, I think, allows the hero to be a lot more proficient than most. Tusk is going to be banned away by Team Secret. Actually looking at maybe that four position Tusk, maybe the offlane Tusk. Either way, he's just one of the stronger heroes left in the pool, and Team Secret didn't really have room for it.
Like, Dazzle is still there, but it does leave them very limited in terms of actual teamfight control outside of the global and the Fisher.
Mm-hmm.
And it would be nice to have that Grave up against someone like the Lina, and then you've got the minus armor from Weave. Visage goes naturally into the Medallion and Solar Crest. But I'm not too sure. Laning-wise, what are we actually looking at? Team Secret could run the Naga Siren plus one, Naga Siren plus Clockwork for the initial stages. Naga Siren does like to go and run dual lanes for the first minute or so. You know, actually get the Riptide out and cause havoc for the one or two position of your opponents. But I really like the Crystal Maiden with the clock as well. Rocket Flare, we've seen Moon Meander go for the max Rocket Flare, right? The level 4 in that and just spam it out incessantly.
Mm-hmm.
You could even do that here. You know that Sansa is going to be really heavily forcing you out of the lane. So just getting any CS that you possibly can.
Yeah, I really value that kind of build just because it allows you to always get farm. Even if your ganks are failing, the global presence of the rocket continually allowing you to be able to get CS, even when you're not in lane. I think there's I think it's a smarter way to build Clockwork most of the time. Despite the fact that, like, oftentimes, you know, I really like the maxed out battery cell for the kill potential it gives you. The fact is, if it's a little bit safer in some regards, especially if you have a critical item that you need to pick up, like, you know, say the blade mail is really efficient in this game or something. You need that item, and if you fail your ganks, you're just not going to get it with a maxed out Q build. So the last man out from VP was the Clinks. We don't have too many carries left for Eternal Envy. Is he going to go something? I feel like they need a little bit of late game power here. Virtus, either that or they get super, super aggressive, because Virtus Pro, I think, have this mid game powerhouse team between the Global Silence, the SF, who really hits a stride, you know, about 25, 30 minutes in. The Earthshaker and Visage, same kind of goes. They're a little bit greedy as supports, but as an offlaner, Earthshaker usually gets a 20 minute blink dagger, and Visage as a forward position just always seems to find farm. I mean, Lil is, without a doubt in my mind, the best Visage out there in the world. Mm-hmm. He plays it so often. So, I would say that they have a very likelihood of getting a pretty fast Solar Crest Aghanim Scepter, you know, 35, 40 minutes in. So they're going to hit this serious mid-game powerhouse, and I'm not sure how Team Secret are going to be able to deal with it. Do they go back to something like the Spectre that they picked up
In
their semifinal?
You need someone that, A, doesn't get kited by Telekinesis, Grave Chill, and then Shadowfiend once he gets, you know, a Scaldi mm-hmm. later on into the game. So I think heroes like Luna are kind of out of the picture almost. Maybe they go with, like, you know, one of the fail-safe heroes for Envy, Razor, the Viper, something like that that gives them some kind of security in the mid-game and they can actually go and fight into this.
That would be a heavy amount of focus on the early game at that point in time, but Razor does offer you a bit of pushing power. What about the Slark here? I'm a little bit nervous about a Slark versus the Earthshaker, and there's the potential of just getting locked down by the Global Silence at the wrong time. But he is. Whoa! All right. So we're gonna go.
Is it one roll Naga?
I was about to say, are we gonna go back for the position Naga Siren? They don't. They have. I mean, Naga Siren, I feel, as a carry, is probably one of the better heroes against the carry silencer. I don't feel you're hindered as much. Like, it's kind of like Doom, right? In that the Global Silence kind of counters, you know, many of these heroes, but Naga Siren's going to be playing for the split push and staying out of these fights a lot of times and just working on that Radiance and et cetera, et cetera. And that just staying away from VP's team fight focused lineup, I think, is pretty valuable. So Puppy already picking up the Venomancer. Venomancer, though, why that sport? I mean, going back to the Naga Siren carry, I think certain things make sense, but why Veno as your other support?
Good at canceling blinks. Stop the Earthshaker blinking in with those plague wards.
Yeah, that's okay. That's a good point.
Outside of that, I'm not 100% sure, actually. Like, you can spam plague wards out onto sort of tier 1, tier 2 towers and hold out the aggression, which will be coming. Like, you know that 20-minute timing is going to be there for the Shadowfiend and the Silencer just to break down towers one by one. But is this just some kind of pocket strat? Because Crystal Maiden is usually the hero you look at thinking, okay, she'll spend some time in the jungle, get to level 3, get the 1-1-1 build, right? What does Puppy do? Like, during the laning phase, what does the Venomancer do? He can zone out the Earthshaker.
Yeah,
not great at rotating,
right.
Not really great at finding openings on other lanes, though.
Mm-hmm. So I just wanted to see if they did scatter out. And it was the early TP. We're seeing a lot of offlaners do this nowadays. They either TP out to their offlane or to the mid lane tower in order to get that ward set up, especially if you're on dire side, because the Radiant camp is so hard to counter ward. You actually need 3 different counters to be 100% sure that it's open. So you oftentimes have this early TP out. Unfortunately for Misery, Lil, as the Visage, TP'd out to the safe lane, got that really aggressive ward out, which I do like quite a bit, and then cut over into his jungle and saw the Clockwork backing out. And there's only one reason Clockwork would be out there that early, and that's in order to ward. So they know it's either on the bush or it's farther down in this area. So they should be able to counter ward and free up their pull, which is incredibly important, obviously, for the Visage's start.
What's going to be VP's way to deal with this Naga once she gets her Radiance? Because I don't feel they can fully stop the Naga getting the relic. they're not going to have that roaming potential very early on. You know, the Visage and the Rubick, they're kind of slow starters. They can't flash farm camps. They can pull and stack and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
But Shadowfiend, you know, aim for the 12-minute mech or something like that for G. Oh, does that sentry catch? Yeah, I see it. They also don't have great contest heroes for the jungle. Shadowfiend plus Earthshaker maybe can go and steal stacks away from the Lina. But apart from that kind of flash farm, they don't have a consistent way of stopping the Naga from going and farming camp by camp.
Oh, he got it!
He's up on the cliff. Nice.
Oh, God, he really wanted that rune, but somebody's going to have to eat out. So God will lose one of his... Or sorry, Lil is actually going to be losing his shared tangos. They gave one of them to replace the lost one on God. But that Cogs was actually so worth it. He got three different burns, as well as forced them to use shared tangos, so... He doesn't get caught in any way for that very aggressive play on the rune and forces it to be picked up on the carry silencer. Now, FNG, he's going to be playing in the middle lane for a little while. Weehaw's going to lose one of his shared tangos. He can't, but he's trying to juggle it all the way back.
That was so close.
Not going to happen.
Cutesy play. So Puppy's just going to be stacking and pulling up here. Are these two heroes both going to jungle? Pileidai and Puppy? The double jungling supports, get themselves to level 34 as fast as they can, then buy time for the Naga Siren just to build up items?
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, we talked about this earlier, where the Earthshaker is as a early pickup as an offlaner, you can deal with him by having certain self-sustained carries, because the Earthshaker can't punish the Naga Siren when he's left alone in this one versus one, so... Puppy just occasionally rotating in is going to be enough to keep the Earthshaker scared. He's going to be sitting back. Yeah, he'll probably get more experience and a little bit more gold than normal as an offlaner against one or two supports, but it's still going to be a pretty rough time for him. Naga starting the free farming. I really like this idea by Team Secret, because I feel like in your analysis you addressed it, the fact that they really don't have good ways to deal with the flip push of Team Secret. Like, the Radiance is going to be picked up, and then once the split push starts happening, VP just have to make certain, like, five-man commitments, and that's never a position you want to be in. You don't want to be rushed into your push uphill, because going uphill is always so dangerous. One to
many, many to one. This early game really does mean so much to them. They've got good laning matchups, honestly. Lil and Illidan forcing Misery back. He's getting some experience, but it's a limited amount, and he's going to be slowed down here, actually.
Yeah, man, with that attack speed slow, they get so many extra auto attacks, and he's dead. The tick count, and that's your first blood. Intelligence going over to Illidan. That's the power of this combination, especially against... That's why Phoenix is so valuable against Clockwork. The attack speed slow in the beginning actually hurts Clockwork so badly, because his cogs sometimes become more of a detriment than an attribute, you know? It's him locked inside of his own cogs, essentially.
More of a hindrance than a help.
Yeah. DK Phobos routinely being pushed back by Puppy. Yeah, Pileidai doing that free jungle. He's also stacking up this hard camp at the same time while he's clearing through the big creeps. He's getting some of the smaller creeps stacked up. So Weehaw will probably easily clear through that a little bit later on to the game.
G, though, he's holding his own. He hasn't really burnt through too much regen. And now they're looking for the kill on mid. Oh, that Lina.
If only. They had the telekinesis there, pull back, double raise, and a couple of right clicks, and they might have actually killed her.
Naga illusions, no!
Yeah.
How annoying can you get?
Earthshaker knows, like, he just has to spam out Fisher for CS, but because he went for this very defensive build, Ring of Protection, Stout Shield, he is going to be severely limited on mana. He's not going to be able to pick up the fast Soul Ring that we see. Also doesn't have the boots to really stay ahead of the support ganks as easily, so the one thing I really do like about TK Phobos's build, he went for the TP scroll. Having that early TP scroll, especially since you know Eternal Envy is very unlikely to have a level of ensnare, there's no stun, so he can just always get himself out of those predicaments.
Yeah, there's like a 1% chance he levels ensnare at this point. Maxing mirror image, getting a Riptide and Song is gonna be the way to go. They might even consider missing Song at level 6, because I don't... Like, they're not going to be fighting, right? The Song is going to be there to try and stop any gank to rotations coming in, but VP, that's going to be commitment from the Visage, Rubick, Earthshaker. Shadowfiend doesn't really want to make a movement up the top unless there's, you know, a Haste Rune, an Invis, something like that, an Activator Rune that gives him an opportunity to actually get up there without missing CS at mid.
Weehaw, I like that play he was doing earlier. In order to ensure he got the siege creep, he was spamming out Light Strike Array uphill to keep God back from going from the deny. Just that animation was doing a lot. These constant rockets, though, in the middle lane, G is being kind of hindered by that one. Always kept at low HP, low enough that he might just die to a Lina combination if he ever gets caught. FNG, whoops. He gets the ward out, but does wake up Roshan.
Yeah, Roshan's bugged.
Lose it. Is he bugged?
Even if you don't aggro him, like by getting too close, if you place a ward on that cliff, he aggroes on you.
Yeah, I was about to say, I felt like, because I did that the other day, and I was like, oh, whoops, I must have gotten just a little bit too close, no. But...
He just hates everyone.
Yeah. Maybe 6.85 will change that.
Yeah, right.
Roshan. 10 years from now, 6.85.
Back in my day.
Alright, DK Phobos will be able to get some opportunity for some CS. Eternal Levy harassing him with that Riptide, but the push is going to come in. And that's what is really important for DK Phobos. In fact, he's now got a Soul Ring. He'll get one of his CS. And, they get the Clockwork again. The combination. They slow him down. It's just so much. So much power. The early level in Global Silence being picked up by Silencer. I wasn't sure if he was going to go for it or not, but it could be necessary on a mid lane gank. Especially, again, as you mentioned in the draft, the combination of the Lina. Being able to interrupt that with the Global Silence could save your solo mid.
The question is, when does Weihao actually move into the jungle to go and pick up these stacks? He spent the first 6 minutes actually farming through. He's hit level 7. And this is kind of the point, they're pinging out now, yeah. This is the point where you want to go and really consolidate this. Where's Misery? No. I was wondering, where's Misery going?
Yeah, Misery might just be here for the experience, XP. Yeah. I mean, it's pretty necessary. He's only level 2 right now.
Come and kill the camps, please.
Weehaw's just refusing for now. Top lane being pushed out by Venomancer wards, the Earthshaker. What can you do? You approach one of those wards and start right-clicking him down. First of all, the HP trade-off is not worth the amount of gold that you're going to get from that one ward. And second of all, the Venomancer is just going to be able to run you down with Venomant Scale, and you may end up dying because of that.
Lina's actually not taking this. It's Maiden and Clockwork. So they're putting a lot of stock into Clock, getting his level 6, at least at a reasonable time.
Mm-hmm.
But Misery, level 2 Rocket Flare. You don't have the stones for this.
Yeah, he doesn't even... He Rocket Flares middle. He's trying to get vision of the camp, but he'll miss it out. SF already cleared through all of that, which is why God is now level 8 to Weehaw's level 7 right now. TP up to the top lane. Silencer's actually going to be able to get the kill on Eternal Levy, and that's huge. They got the tower, but immediately some of that unreliable gold is going to be taken away from the Naga Siren. Only sitting at 1600, you could see she was building up for the relic right now, not stopping for any other stat items. And that's completely hindered by that death.
This is why I was... Like, obviously, the song there, it doesn't make a difference whether you have it or not. But the fact that you're spamming out Riptide and Mirror Image, you don't have really the actual mana pool to do both and then have song as well. Then Global Silence comes in, you're not going to be able to cast song anyway. So it's kind of interesting that he's gone for it. He went for it at level 6.
Oh, FNG, he's been caught. He thought he was hidden from vision, but the ward does scout him out. Still, the Laguna Blade used for a support. And Visage, this is one of the big powers of the Visage, is a 4 position, being left alone in the lane. You can easily just solo out the offlaner.
Oh god, is G dead? Oh, he's 8 stick charges, he's fine. Weihaw might commit to this, no? Realizes TP's coming in, bottle gets exchanged across.
The flare comes out, ooh, the Dragon Slave, and he's forced into that, the use of the charges.
Regen rune up at top, how lucky can you get?
Weihaw's gonna be a happy camper with that one. He's starting to build into his Yule Scepter right now.
Misery's going to be found here, though, by Illidan. They've got a slow from this last word.
Oh, yeah, they could easily catch him. Grave Chill's going to be there to catch up even more. And Misery is just slowly but surely run down. A couple of right clicks and a Soul Assumption. Maybe they could get the kill here. Nice Cogs push back. Lil, though. Phil throws it out, but it's not enough.
I really like that change, by the way. The last word change, right? No longer disarms, it gives you that percentage-based slow. It still feels like, you know, a hidden part of the spell, you don't really notice it.
But it's so deadly for chasing now. It's so much better, I think, for the safe lane silencer.
Yeah.
When it comes to spamming out against the offlaner. Because they really do have to back up. Before, you could just kind of like sit there and go, okay, I'm silenced and disarmed, but I'm still in range of experience. That's fine. But if you're slowed down like that, it obviously leaves yourself open to being chased down.
So Clockwork has 17 intelligence. 208 mana.
Oh yeah, Clockwork does not have much mana to work with. This matchup for Clockwork is actually so terrible for multiple reasons.
It's worse than being against the Huskar almost.
Yeah, he's stuck in this situation where he's not going to have his combo. Like, he'll get to level 6.
He'll hookshot and cogs and that's it.
Yeah, and he may not have battery assault. He can't, like, he'll have battery assault or rocket, but not both. Which is pretty awkward because do you choose the battery assault, but it's only level 1.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Makes it even worse when you go for the maxed out rocket build.
So, with the magic stick for aggressive plays. Oh god, he's taking a pounding here from Illidan.
Yeah, he really does. Just two shots, and he's already brought down to 260 HP. DK Fobo says the fellow offlaner is level 6, so he's doing a bit better than Misery is right now.
Geez, Shadowfiend though, man. Max nearly finished.
They're gonna hit,
Wait, is mech fin- oh god, he's actually got it.
Oh wow.
11 minute mech.
What great timing, gee. 100 CS, on the mark, 10 denies, 0-0-0.
With a magic wand as well. Damn.
10xing his lane.
It just goes to show you how great FNG has been doing, stacking these camps over and over
Level
again.
Level silence, they're gonna go for the bottom lane kill. Weehaw, he's gonna die here to the Fate Bolt, but FNG's gonna be the turnaround kill, so... And plus, they don't lose any intelligence, which is pretty important. So a 2-for-1 trade-off, global silence used, Team Secret get a great fight at the bottom lane.
Oh, definitely. Killing off Illidan there is such a big deal as well, because he's... Like, he would have had Rod of Atos with the kill first, and then maybe getting away, picks up the two staffs of wizardry. And then that really opens things up. That's when they start hitting their timing I was mentioning before, where they do group up as 5 and push into these tier 1s. Shadowfiend mech, Rod of Aether Silencer, and Earthshaker hitting level 6 with his Tranquils and Soul Ring. Actually go and press the issue, and maybe go and contest this Narcissiren. But she has been given free birth now, so just go and get that relic.
Yeah, this is... unless they get her at the rune here, this could be big. Fisher, DK Phobos hits it, but Eternal Envy's already healed up a little bit and will be able to get the bottle heal enough, so he's got the relic. And unless they just immediately charge into the jungle and catch him, he'll have the gold for it. So relic by 12 minutes, you're probably looking at like an 18 minute radiance at the latest. And anything before 20 is acceptable. They're gonna run into him now, they'll find him right before he has it. Oh no, DK Phobos, you need the Echo Slam. Got it. Oh, what a gigantic kill. They only make Eternal Envy lose like 200 gold, but that's still enough to stall up his relic for a full minute. Oh, and look at this turnaround. They're going to run right into Weehaw here. Illidan throws out the silence. Weehaw starts running himself away, turns around for the Light Strike Array, but Pylite Eye is already dead. Hookshot in from Misery. Not much that can happen there. And Weehaw, they're just going to try and run him down. TP out. Do they have the burst damage they're going to need to raise? Not in time. Weehaw gets out middle lane,
Puppy's
though. Puppy's going to go down. Pew, pew. And familiars get him.
Virtus Pro. Reaction times. But they kind of know... with the two-man movement up to the Nagasaren, there were no reaction TPs, no one to save her up there. No one farming the jungle, so where are the rest of the Dire Heroes? Must be going for some kind of play towards mid or bottom lane, so... G with that mech. They can actually now push into the bot tier 1 if they wanted to, but just making the most of their own jungle. And Illidan, Atos, done. Medallion for that Visage, everything is... coming out golden here for Virtus Pro.
Yeah, certainly. 7-3 right now, VP. They still have to worry about the Nagasaren. Just because they shut her down once, the relic is still there. And I really feel like Virtus Pro, they have to hit so hard. In like 25 minutes, you know that Radiance is going to be up. They have to just like run at buildings and try and go uphill. And all the meanwhile, you're going to be feeling the constant Nagasaren, Radiance, and Riptide spam, which is so tough to deal with, especially in the early game where it takes such a high percentage of your HP away.
If she doesn't die again and she gets a Bounty Rune up at top, she'll probably have a 60-minute Radiance regardless.
Yeah. DK Fobo's going to be caught here. Light Strike Array does catch him, and a Laguna Blade to finish him off. Weeha, now level 11.
I think Poppy's going for a Veil. He's got an Null Talisman.
Ooh. What? You think he's just... Do you think he goes for the Veil right away, though? That feels like a very awkward first item. Like, I would really like Blink Dagger. Blink Dagger, then Veil. I mean, it's such a one-off combination for a support. You don't really care about the Global Silence that much. As long as you get off your R button, you're good.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I kind of like it if they've got the Hookshot plus the Freezing Field and that Poison Nova.
Mm-hmm.
But Global Silence really messes up combinations in team fights.
That's why I feel it's so necessary for you to have. Oh, Illidan, he will be able to get the... Oh, he has to cancel his TP in order to get the kill on the Venomancer, which means Misery will pick up the turnaround kill. So that was a little awkward. He thought he was going to be able to get it and just TP back, but...
Puppy stick charges.
Yeah.
Oh man, look at this Nagasaren. How close is she right now to the Radiance? 300. Hiding away behind the tier 2 tower.
They're hunting for so heavily. Weeha is hiding in the trees here. How long is that smoke? Yeah, the smoke's already gone. So they won't be able to find anything. Clockwork now has a blade mail. So that's significant, especially against the SF, who's so susceptible to that. Weeha just TPs himself out.
I wonder if you could get away with a late Midas here for Puppy. 16 minutes in, it's like depending on... Because you know the Nagasaren's going to drag it late, right? You're going to be starved of farm. Lina's going to go for a Bloodstone just to give her that sort of late game spam capability to keep her farm going. And obviously the reduction in her respawn time in case she dies is great as well.
And you do really need experience on a Venomancer, so I could see where you're going with that.
I'm just not sure if it's too late.
Yeah, might be. The slow Rod of Atos, long range there. Light Strike Array will immediately blow off FNG as he just charges forward a little bit too. And now Illidan's going to be hit by the Laguna Blade. They will be able to finish him off. Misery is the turnaround kill. A 1-for-2 so far, but Eternal Envy, he's going to set up another combination for Weeha, which I'm sure is going to mean another kill. The Familiar's actually causing a little bit of havoc here, and it looks like DK Phobos still going to be caught here. Echo Slam gets laid out, controlling Eternal Envy, but there's just not enough mana on G right now to go for that finishing move. So he just turns around, gets another off Enchant Totem, but God has to make the turnaround play, gets one raise. Can he hit the other one here? The Ensnare holding him in, he will end up going down.
Really?
And that is almost a wipe.
Really?
Lil's the only one to escape.
Amazingly. Well played there from Secret. I saw the Crystal Maiden in the back and I thought, oh god, this Freezing Field is going to come through onto the song, but she didn't have mana for it. But the threat of the Crystal Maiden in the back kind of splits up versus Pro, the Shadow Fiend running up to the north, and DK Phobos thought that he could battle it out with the other heroes in the middle. The Nagasaren is deceptively tanky with 9 plus, 12 armor, a decent amount of HP, but giving a Naga a couple of kills, that is really detrimental to your efforts, pushing her even closer to the BOTs and to that Manta-style Octarine Core build that I'm kind of assuming is going to come out here from her. It's become the standard, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let's keep those illusions pumping out as much as you can. Puppy, come on, show me the money. Show me the money. 1,600 gold. What are you going to buy? It's going to be a blink, isn't it?
Yeah, I think
so. You're going to be right.
I think the blink dagger is just too valuable.
I hate it when you're right.
Because the push is going to come in. Though, I mean, the hand of Midas really wouldn't be that bad because he's got to get blink. Whoa. He wants to get Veil. He wants to get Aghanim Scepter. Boots of Travel, TP in. They're going to be able to get the pick off on DK Phobos. And Lil really can't actually do much against Eternal Envy here. He's going to be going down as well. The attempted run by Illidan is coming out. Oh, Eternal Envy! He almost gets popped there, but it's not quite enough. The medallion isn't enough. Misery, though, may be caught as looks like last right click in from Illidan just before he touches the cogs is enough. He's going to be run down by these illusions and is going to be forced to TP out. The
dead?
Damage. Oh my god! He dies inside the fountain.
We
went down to
Radiant
one.
Jungle?
I don't understand.
He got the stun off the G and he runs himself away.
How did that happen? He went down to 1 HP and then he got in the fountain. I saw him go up in HP.
This is a video game. Welcome, everyone, to Defense of the Ancients. Where the rules are made up and, nothing else matters, literally.
I guess there was just an extra Radiance Burn tick that cleared through. Man, I was gonna freak out if you lived with one HP though. There's the Veil. So no Blink Dagger. Both of us are wrong.
Ah!
I mean, you did say Veil to begin.
But then I backed out and said Midas.
Yeah. But you had the right idea. So, Veil. What? Then Blink Dagger, then Aghanim Scepter? Or do you think you just go in all out damage and go Aghanim Scepter next?
Veil, then Midas.
Veil, then Midas. No. Please, no.
The legit 27 minute Midas coming out of Puppy.
So Puppy's just been calmly farming away through these Ancients. Team Secret are really making the best. Like, the Nagasarn's going to take up so much of the room, but with Puppy taking advantage, like, as a four position, farming up Ancients, that's very, very rare. Very few heroes can do that. Like, Shadow Shaman, we used to see that all the time where he used his Serpent Warns to clear through Ancient stacks, but that was, like, one of the only other scenarios where that would happen. So it's very efficient use of the map so far. Oh, an early stage proc on a Puppy, but Misery's gonna be able to respond. Now they get the ultimate out, Global Silence, but perhaps it's just a bit too light. Light Strike Array lands from FNG, who stole that earlier. They've locked in the clockwork, but
song.
With that Poison Nova ticking away, Eternal Envy, is he gonna make the song play here? He knows everybody's probably pretty low. He's gonna run into Lil. Lil gets the Grave Chill out.
Look at them all though, with a Veil plus Poison Nova. FNG is not gonna die.
Oh, the rockets! Misery finds them. Now they'll catch DK Phobos as well. And this is the power of this combination. Once you get that ultimate out from the Venomancer, it's just too late. The Nagasarn will tick away at you with those illusions, the Riptide, the Radiance.
And the difference there between VP getting out without any casualties and losing two heroes there, also the Shadow Fiend having to pop mech and run back to base, is that 0.5 second window where Global Silence came just after the Poison Nova.
Yeah. If they'd gotten that, they probably would have killed Misery and everyone would have stayed alive. But as it is, the second too late still means a few members of VP die. It's 11-14 right now, 21 minutes in. EP, you could see, had that early lead with the SF being able to farm so much, but now he may be picked off. Weeha's gonna go, well, he doesn't have Laguna Blade, so he's committing pretty heavily for a kill that he can't burst down. Now he's gonna be chased, FNG, hoping to be able to catch up, throws out the ward, steals Crystal Nova. I always forget the name of that ability. Puppy, Rod of Atos, double slowed down here in the Fissure, yeah. They'll get that kill.
The one, I guess there's two heroes on the map that really are not getting anything. FNG's Rubick sitting at the bottom of the net worth table, and Pylite on the Crystal Maiden, sure, he's a walking aura with the arcane aura. Pretty nice, but no items. Tranquils and Magic Stick, that's all he's got. And now Rubick picks up his Tranquils, feeling happy about himself.
Yeah, everyone else on the side of Secret is using the jungle and the Ancients and lanes so efficiently that there's just not any room for Pylite Eye to jungle anymore. So there's probably not going to be, unless he managed to get in a fight and survives, there's not going to be that any Glimmer Cape, BKB, or Aghanims for the Crystal Main.
Well, Eternal Envy, BOTs, and straight into the Octarine Core, skipping over Yasha Mantastyle, who just wants to pump out these illusions eternally.
I don't love it. I mean, the Octarine Core is so valuable on the new Naga Siren. Just spamming out all these illusions, you get more Riptides. It's a decent tanking item as well. Song is up on a lot more. Yeah, I mean, every single aspect of it. Yeah. It's Ensnare, what did the downtime go to? It's a 5 second hold with a 12 second cooldown, but then that jumps down to 9 seconds. So what, you have like a 4 second downtime on Ensnare?
Just keep throwing them out.
Yeah. Even that is like, that's like the worst part of Octarine Core is the 4 second downtime in Snare, and even that's so absurd. Look at the harassment they're dealing out right now between the rocket, the long range Crystal Nova, the wards, everything is just running at them and they don't have the room. Weiha, he's gonna be kind of caught here. FNG's gonna be able to, no, nice Yule Step, he's gonna turn around, Light Strike Array kind of misses it and will be popping. The Lina, FNG picks up that kill, and Misery, he's pretty overextended, but does get a four staff out right over the cliff. Very slick move.
They kind of know that there's vision up here on this high ground, though. The way that Misery came in from the side and then four staff himself back, they know they've got intel in this area, so it's just a matter of scouting out and finding out their observer ward. Did they just smoke under it? They pinged out this observer ward spot, and the they brought sentries in. Like, I'm pretty sure that Lil's gonna sentry this up now. Yeah,
yeah.
Oh god.
Missed opportunity there, I guess. Smoke down, Octarine Core now up, and Boots of Travel for the Lina. And VP, they're left with this awkward scenario. Are they going to be forced to go late game against Naga Siren? That's not ideal. But at this rate, I'm not sure how they're ever going to be able to get a real good grasp on this game to take some map control and push forward. There's just not enough space for them to go for objectives. They're always being pushed in by Lucians or Venomancer wards.
And DK Phobos, he says, you know what, screw Blink Dagger. I'm never going to be able to use this. With Plague Wards, with Radiance Illusions, with all the crap flying out from Crystal Nova and Rocket Flares, just straight into the Force Staff. But you're right. How do they handle these Naga Illusions? You know, farming their jungle, choke holding them into this position where they're basically hemmed onto their side of the river.
Mm-hmm.
They need Secret to walk into them. They need to set some kind of trap. I don't know whether it's going to be tier 2 bot. I guess if you wanted to defend that, you could maybe try and set up there. But then you're walking into Song, into all of these good initiation tools that Secret have. Follow it up with Weihar's level 3 Laguna Blade. So just trying to split the map and outfarm.
Weihar, careful, friend. You might be a little overextended here. He's fast once he regains his movement speed. And he will stay ahead of Illidan until Force Staff comes in. Another right click. Oh, Weihar barely survives. Meanwhile, the fight up here in the top lane. Rubik's already gone. They snare into God. They're just making sure to kite him around as much as possible to get off the Poison Nova. And DK Phobos, he's got to be dead from this one. Force Staff, whoa, will not matter. He's just going to get caught. God actually managed to take out those illusions. That was a really great play. If that saves DK Phobos, I'll be impressed. But that maybe just puts him in serious danger as he's going to be caught by another snare. Pops the BKB, turns around. Wait, huh? What? 40 HP once again. Lil comes in from the side. He's going to go for the quick kill. As Weha.
Look at Misery.
Oh my god, Yule Scepter, don't tell me. Alright, he finally loses that. But it's gonna be at the cost of Lil. Misery very deep in. Lil's now gonna try and get out. Turns around onto Puppy, trying to go for that quick kill. Doesn't have enough damage. Puppy will end up surviving. And looks like Illidan will get out. So they do save DK Phobos and keep God alive. They take away the Aegis in exchange for Lil's life. That wasn't a bad disengage, but how many more times can they play around that combination from Team Secret?
The big hesitation from Eternal Envy as well. He had Ensnare up for a good 2 seconds or so. Saw the Earthshaker, saw the Shadow Fiend. And in that situation, I was with you. Like, Earthshaker's dead, right? Just go for the Shadow Fiend. But he couldn't quite decide and left it very late for the SF to actually get himself a good distance away. So they missed out on both of the kills. Then Misery was trying to chase them down. He actually sort of herded them back towards their base, so the Earthshaker couldn't come back in for a Fisher. If he had, VP could have actually taken that fight not too badly, with the Earthshaker coming back in, maybe giving up his life for a Force Echo Slam into the middle of them. But Misery managed to push them all back. And Weihar is actually going into the Aghanim Scepter. I'm assuming, with the extra point booster. The Shadow Fiend, obviously, primary target for that with that BKB.
Minutes in, 14-16. Oh dear god, runs right into Light Strike Array, but Weihar knows enough. He's got to back out. He can't commit for a kill here.
They've managed to hold their own.
Yeah.
Puppy, he's just a farming machine right now. He's got an Ogre Club now. Is this building... I mean, if you're going Aghanim Scepter, you usually would pick up the point booster. Especially given how Venomancer is a little bit limited in mana pool right now. So is he actually going BKB? Is he looking to just be able to stop that Global Silence as best as possible?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. This will allow him to be able to barrel in. Man, the movement speed on the Lina. They get these slows from the silencer, but it's just still never enough. Misery is going to be catching FNG here. Quick kill should be anyways. He still ends up going out. God pops the ultimate with the BKB on the side. Global silence buying some time, but now Puppy's going to come in from the side. He doesn't actually have enough mana, so Illidan commits for him. Managed to get the kill. Weihar turns around, but DK Phobos Echo Slam holds him in, and they will be able to catch Weihar here. He commits Bloodstone Suicide, but still, it's going to be Illidan and DK Phobos
song.
Trying to get out. The song cancels the TP. And DK Phobos, He's going to have to make some sort of great Fisher play if they want to be able to save Illidan, but he's immediately going to be bumped by the Kongs. Illidan is going to be chased down. Forstaff over into the neutrals, but he dies as the Radiance takes him down once again. They pick up both of those kills. The Song of Siren stops, and only God is the survivor.
Virtus Pro severely lacking mobility and utility. And you can see the Silencer now with the Shadow Amulet. He knows he needs more. Forstaff is just not quite enough. Visage with the Solar Crest is doing a damn good job, but FNG on this Rubick, you know, with no blink, with no way of getting himself in and out of team fights to steal spells, because there are some big spells to actually...
Okay. All right, the hookshot misses, but the Yulz does not. FNG will die. And I think Virtus Pro are kind of at the end of their rope by now.
There's a glimmer on the Crystal Maiden. She has created a gap between herself and this Rubick now. They were comrades.
That net worth lead is just constantly dropping more and more and more. 30 minutes in, we have a 12,000 gold lead.
And you can see this sort of, it's almost like the tidal pressure, you know, as the day goes on. At first, VP was sort of held into this position where they couldn't go past the river. And then slowly but surely, it's just been back and back and back. And now they're stuck inside their base with these Naga illusions pushing them forward. There is not a single lane pushed out here. They can't control their jungle. There's Dire Vision watching pretty much every move they make.
There's just never enough smokes. Like, that's the one thing that allows them to be able to push out and catch heroes when they're being crowded like this. Illidan dropped his Shadowblade while he's farming there earlier just to be able to see if he can get some sort of catch with the Shadowblade surprise, but that's not going to happen. Nobody's here. Just runs into wards. So they ping him out, and I'm sure they saw the Shadowblade, so no opportunity for a free kill.
Well, Captain Puppy, what are you going to make? 2,600 gold saved up. There's the Aghanims.
Okay.
Point boosters purchased.
I think he was kind of hemming and hawing.
Yeah.
Because, BKB would be a great way for you to be able to get in there and still make sure you get off your Poison Nova, because even if you pop it before the Global Sounds and say you need to because you're being, you know, attacked for some reason, chances are you'll survive through the Global Sounds time in order to get off the Poison Nova, unless you're just getting hardcore focused.
But yeah, a ton of the damage, if not most of the damage from VP, is magical. You know, the glaives from Illidan, the pure damage out from there, can't go through the BKB. And Shadow Fiend is really the only right clicker. Everything else, the Soul Assumption, the Earthshaker damage output, it's all magical.
Jesus, Illidan does a little bit more damage than I expected. He's doing 190 damage a shot right now without Glaives of Wisdom. So I guess his physical damage isn't bad, but I agree with you. I think that the physical damage just would be a little too limited.
He has to use Shadow Blade to kill off the illusions. Here comes Misery, though.
Misery has an Aghanim Scepter. So he's willing to just throw those around. Now they're going to be able to catch him. Illidan doesn't even get the chance to throw out the Global Silence, and he has no buyback for a full minute. Team Secret don't even need to push uphill if they don't want to at this point.
What's stopping them? If they can have an illusion go and chase the Earthshaker, I guess he can still force
that. Oh, Misery? I'm not sure what that was, but he was a bit too far forward. Now he's going to be pulled back, telekinesis, and yeah, that was about to say, that's got to be some sort of misclick. But if he can move up force staff and he still has a hook shot out, he will survive. Really showing the lack of offensive capabilities for Virtus Pro when their silencer is down.
Look at these Naga illusions though. Just chase one after the Earthshaker and make sure that he is not safe. He's not really feeling too healthy to jump in with the Echo Slam. Because he wants to stay alive. He wants to be able to cast multiple cycles of his spells to be able to win in this fight for VP. It's not just about the Echo Slam. It's about the, you know, 6.5 seconds of chain stun afterwards with the Fisher and Enchant Totem as well. To actually hold down this Naga Siren, stop her from getting the song out.
I think you kind of need to go for Shadowblade next. Like, again, the Blink Dagger just doesn't seem like a real possibility. I mean, if you're going to get an initiation, yeah, go the Glimmer Cape and then the Shadow Blade afterwards, because DK Phobos, unless he's blinking in to a certain range so he can then force staff the rest of the way in, I don't see how he's ever just going to be able to blink ulti. So many Naga Siren illusions, wards, yeah.
Everything gets in the way. Only Rags is up for Puppy. Has EE? Yeah. Oh, wow. Okay. Level 2 Diffusal Blade just purchased like that. And Roshan respawns in about 2 minutes' time. So pretty, you know, pretty long respawn time there on the old Rosh.
Yeah, there really is no reason for Seeker to rush it. Whoa, hookshot. He thought he was going on to DK Phobos, but he realizes there's an invis target right in front of him, and he's dead. So up to 20 stolen intelligence now for the Silencer.
And he steals a streak. It doesn't put him closer to a big item, though. What do we usually see from Illidan after this? Like, BKB wouldn't be bad. AC is kind of the physical damage output carry Silencer build after this, but I
think you almost have to go BKB. There's so much...
Yeah.
The Radiance Burn, the Poison Nova, the combination of the Lina. Like, if you're hit by the Yule Sifter, you shouldn't be able to get Global Silence off. The Light Strike Array should always cut you before you get that, the Global Silence animation off.
Oh, there's your Blink on Earthshaker. And an MKB done for G. At this point, I was almost wondering if he goes for something, you know, like the Mjolnir, just to try and clear out these Naga Illusions, deal with it that way. He goes for the full damage. If he can stand his ground, if he can buy a Satanic in the next... Let's say 10 minutes. If they can hold out for 10 minutes and get him a Satanic, they still have a good chance at holding out in this game. Going for the Roshan after this one, and then actually building things up to battle the rest of the heroes apart from Nagasaren. Because if you look at the rest of Secret, what late game potential do they have? The Lina has gone for pretty much full caster. The Aghanim Scepter, Bloodstone, Yule Scepter, you know, there's no Desolator, there's no right-click physical damage coming out from her. The Crystal Maiden and the Clockwork Venno, they are all teamfight control. They're all magical damage, trying to hold people in place and deal with them that way. Virtus Pro have, you know, seemingly better late game. It's just this Naga Siren. This is the hero, Eternal Envy Naga.
Yeah, it's... The problem is that even once you have the... I mean, Illidan's just taking shots in the dark at this point in time. Like, he's just sitting up here with his Shadow Blade, and once the lane pushes in at a certain point, he Shadow Blades all the way through, hoping to be able to catch somebody, but there's just nobody there. Even if you do have the better fighting capability, even if you could win a 5v5, there's no reason for Team Secret to ever give you that opportunity. They'll just continually chip down at you. So that's going to be Roshan. Aegis for... I don't even think you give it to Eternal Envy. Not even close. Like, he's so tanky. Just give it a Weeha.
Yeah. And they smoke up as well. I mean, it's a relatively common and almost obvious smoke that you play. And the fact they've put Eternal Envy up at top, it... See, as VP, I'd feel that there's multiple people sitting behind Eternal Envy here, but they're actually moving down to bot, looking for a pickoff down there. And the fake TP up the top lane, Virtus Pro, they all bail. They could have killed Eternal Envy there, feasibly, with four heroes around. That's a really smart movement, actually, from Secret.
Highlight Eye gets a ward up, and there's no countervision. So this gives Team Secret even more opportunities to maybe find that opening for initiation, but at the same time, it's even just the intel that you get from this, being able to split push the lane where the heroes are not, or knowing when to be able to push uphill and get some extra damage on that tier 3 tower, you're just going to chip away at all these buildings all at once.
Make or break moment, Illidan.
They got to get an initiation here, but the problem is they've been scouted the moment Illidan moves forward. He's just going to be blown up, four staffs to the side. He will manage to get away from that one, but Misery comes in. Oh, the cogs. He finishes off Illidan in a nice pushback on both him and God. Now Eternal Envy's forcing the ultimate in Snare, and God is actually stuck here. They're going to wait out the Song of Siren. Weeha's going to make the initiation now with a Light Strike Array, trying to blow him up. Weeha actually in some trouble, is going to lose his Aegis. No, Yule Scepter actually keeps him alive, but God will end up going down here. Echo Slam gets laid out. Eternal Envy's actually the one to fall. How is God still alive through all of this one? Weeha starts right-clicking down DK Phobos, Familiars, control as best as possible. Four staff ahead of the Dragon Slave and Weiha. He's going to lose his Aegis underneath this tier 3 tower. Now Lil's here. He's back in business and looking to be able to body block up Weiha as much as possible. A good Fissure block is a good thing to start. Light Strike Array gets laid out. Enchant Totem knocking out Weiha. Yule Scepter, but with their good race, they'll be able to finish him off. Bloodstone Suicide towards the end, but DK Phobos and God both survive. Despite being down to 1500 HP, they somehow continue on and beat Team Secret in a straight up team fight with an Aegis.
And that was with Illidan dead, not using Global Silence.
Yeah.
I've got to say, Weiha there, staying on the bottom of the ramp while Misery went in, the Nargothrond got caught, down to half HP from the Requiem. Weiha didn't seem like he wanted to use the Aegis aggressively. So I feel there was some kind of communication barrier there, some kind of miscommunication anyway, where half the team kind of wanted to retreat, the other half wanted to go in and finish off G. Because, what, two or three hits, and that Shadow Fiend was dead. That was it. And then he has to come back to life with half souls, no real way of defending them. Tier 3, you know, it's like domino effect. You just get one after the other after the other. But Eternal Envy just got ripped to shreds. Absolutely destroyed. And if VP can hold like this, the Satanic from G, what was the time I gave him? 10 minutes from like 5 minutes ago?
Glimmer Keep goes out, Puppy still silenced up, won't have the opportunity to get off his ultimate. Hookshot in, Misery is going to be able to jump in, immediately force staff by Illidan. And now Misery's the one who's actually, oh, Laguna Blade comes out, and there goes Illidan. They're going to try and catch up. God, Yule Scepter onto DK Phobos, familiar drop, not going to be in time to stop the combination, but maybe DK Phobos can still get off the Fissure at the very least. God held in by the Frostbite, FNG moves forward, Telekinesis, they're going to right click down, Weiha just in time, Eternal Envy, not in time with the ultimate. But now they're going to have the full out fight here. Cogs is going to push back both God and FNG with a buyback on Weiha. This should be a pretty easy fight for them to take. FNG just going to try and TP out, but a snare catches them towards the end. DK Phobos, who did buy back earlier, has to blink himself back away now. There is a buyback on the SF. They're going to be forced into that one, but Illidan does not have one. He's down for 30 seconds.
And again, no global. This time, though, they paid for it pretty heavily. Lina. We're back to come back into this fight. They're also pushing down a bottom lane. Eternal Envy making short work of the tier 3.
Oh, Echo Slave initiation. DK Phobos actually goes into the middle lane to try and finish him up. Familiar drop. They will be able to catch Weiha. Nice start out, but the SF dies in the bottom lane. He's dead for 2 minutes. Eternal Envy now looking to be able to clean up these racks. Lil fighting alone is the Visage. Only so much he can do in this situation. He will die as well. A buyback. Well, they do have Illidan. A buyback on the Visage, and maybe, just maybe, they can hold. We'll see. Illidan TP's in. Goes straight for Misery. The Blade Mail is going to return a lot of damage back to him. Misery does end up going down, but now Illidan has to fight up against Eternal Envy and all of those control. But look at the familiar drops. They're actually able to keep Eternal Envy locked in. Enchant Totem, Echo Slam, not yet available for DK Phobos, so can't really take advantage of all these illusions, but they are just controlling him, kiting him around as best as possible. Eternal Envy now has the opening as the Fissure goes down, but he pops the Eye of the Storm. Now he's going to be able to turn, maybe. As the Song of Siren goes out, and Puppy's going to be able to get a great ultimate here on multiple. No, four step away. Illidan's able to stay one step ahead of that one. DK Phobos frantically trying to get back to the fountain ahead of the illusions. They will be able to keep those heroes alive, but the melee Rax is going to go down. Team Secret will be able to claim one full line of Rax for all of this trouble.
They got the like-for-like trade. The Shadow Fiend and Lina both being traded off, but again, they do not have anything to deal with the Naga. She's diving fountain with illusions and killing heroes
FNG.
Where they really should be safe.
Poor guy, he ends up going down. Puppy actually poking for more here, but this is still Illidan up with two of the best supporting crew he can have. DK Phobos on the Earthshaker and the Visage ready to go. So he's got to be a little bit careful.
Shadow Fiend's still dead, 25 seconds. Weiha though, the Bloodstone bringing him back to life a little bit faster.
They'll start Illidan. Chipping away. These illusions are already causing so much havoc. They go for DK Phobos' illusion first because he does have that Echo Slam coming up quite soon here. It's now up as soon as they take away the illusion. The melee Rax is already gone, though, and Team Secret, they're going to stick around for the range one as well. DK Phobos is not going to be here. They're going to have to center up on the top lane of Rax with the SF coming back, and Team Secret, they're actually going to stick around. They go for next tier 3 tower. The smoke up is here. Illidan looking to make that initiation alongside DK Phobos. Unable to get the blink just yet. Now makes the initiation onto Weiha. Global silence immediately responded, but the Glimmer Cape is actually buying Weiha time. Now the Siren gets laid out once again, and Puppy positioning himself for a big Poison Nova will be able to coat a number of heroes with the initiation on the side from Misery.
Stolen
he's going to be able
song.
To stall up a little bit of God. FNG, can he turn this one around? Illidan just barely managed to get the kill onto two, but
That's
God
it.
Is going to go down there, and Team Secret just running over all these heroes. They're just too damn weak on the side. side of Virtus Pro don't have the HP pool to contest with that Poison Nova. Team Secret now moving forward. They lead that just last range wreck, the FNG calls it. They know with only Illidan and Lil, there's not nearly going to be enough firepower for them to push back Team Secret, especially Eternal Envy, who's still operating on full HP. Team Secret finish things off finally, and will take game number one in the WCA Grand Finals.
That Sansa pick would have worked so well against the support Naga. You know, we talk about the global Sansa being great at stopping the Naga Song of the Siren from resetting fights and bringing things back into control. Mm-hmm. But the fact there, like, that fight was really a great showcase of Eternal Envy on the Naga Siren. His Manta was on cooldown for like 3 or 4 seconds, but he had the Fusil.